Und damit ein herzliches Willkommen und Hallo zu dem Finale der Okeanos-Kampagne. Ich bin es, euer MC Muffix. Wo ist das? Muss ich, also, ihr wisst, was man machen muss, um das Item zu bekommen, was man will. Einfach mal schnell einen Demon-God-Pillar zu bekommen, bezwingen. So, 65 Millionen, wir sind reich, Babys. Leute, beim letzten Mal haben wir es endlich geschafft, den Demon-God-Pillar Fornios, einen der 72 Dämonenfürsten hier zu töten. Das heißt, es fehlen nur noch 70. Wir sind fast fertig. Dies bedeutet aber auch, dass in Wahrheit Medea die Strippen gezogen hat. Und ja, sie hat wieder hier von dem wahren König Solomon hier geredet. Was natürlich bedeutet, dass die große Bedrehung immer hier noch voransteht. Nichtsdestotrotz sollte ja die Singularität hier sich nun auflösen, da wir den Heiligen Gral hoffentlich nun erhalten. Ricardo, Master. Are you okay? Yes. Oh. Medea! 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 Yes, Jason, is something wrong? Fix me, my Medea. It hurts, it hurts, it really hurts. What are you doing, you slowpoke? I said fix me! I can't do that, Jason. I'm sorry. Huh? I'll be failing soon myself. It's such a pity. Originally the world would have sunk with you. Why you? Just as I thought. Although it has nothing to do with me, but it's true that I did know you. Even as we speak, the memories of Princess Medea are coming back to me. Even if she was betrayed, even if she was cursed at, even if she had been deceived from the very start. She truly, truly adored her Lord Jason, yet been given divine power, yet. You were endlessly innocent, like a child excited over receiving a paltry treasure. You were hopeless, cruel and completely innocent, despite being weak. You attracted others and inspired loyalty. That's who you were, Jason. That was her first love. But you were quick to betray everything. That's the only way you knew how to live. If so, isn't it easier to sing along with the world, so that you want to be betrayed?
Genau, das war nämlich Medeas Plan hier. Sie tut sich dieses unschuldige Wesen aufrechterhalten. Die Welt wird untergehen und alle werden sterben. Aber sie wird nicht hintergangen. Sie ist also in Wahrheit der Grund für die Anomalität hier.
You were never supposed to return to your land.
Damn witch. You treacherous damn bitch. Die, die. Go to hell, damn it. Damn it, damn it.
I'm so little, Jason. I wanted to protect you from him. But I had no way of doing so. I don't have much time left. I only wish I could have dreamed a beautiful dream in my final moments.
Medea is about to vanish. No, before she does. Maxi, you have to ask her. Who's behind all this?
I'm no longer at liberty to tell you that, since I have lost to him as a mage.
Princess Medea, the mage, not the servant, was defeated. In other words...
Yes. Please be sure to prepare yourself. News and the last mages from a distant era. You don't stand a chance against them. As mages, you have no prayer of defeating him. So, go get us stars. Numerous dazzling stars. Stars that can rise against the greed and beast hidden within man's heart. Stars that can remain bright, even within a storm and light up the sky. Elimination confirmed. Holy Grail collection complete. No enemies left. And combat actions. Error correction complete.
Und das heißt Abschied nehmen, oder?
The winter stopped long. Ah, this is the end. There's nothing that can be done. The sea will end soon, but not anything like the giant whirlpool earlier. This is a good ending. It's a new birth. Our sea is coming back to us.
Hey, it's goodbye to this damn weird sea.
We did it, man. Can't say I won't miss it, though. After all, these waters were full of adventure.
Hey, we're vanishing one after another. Guess that's how life works. The rank and file exist first. Master Max is here. Thanks for helping the captain. We get hanged sooner or later, but you're good folk. Let this be a lesson. Never keep the company of pirates.
Everyone. Ha! We can finally go home. Come on, Orion. A new journey of love awaits.
This is supposed to be a nice goodbye scene. Don't you want to get a look cool? Oh, forget it. I'm tired. Well, I hope we can meet again with me in a different form. Farewell. Oh, and Matt, how about the kiss goodbye for a good measure? No. Okay.
Darling, how about a goodbye from me?
I'm sorry.
Ach Leute, das Liebespaar Orion und Artemis waren so unterhaltsam, so nett, so lustig. Hat mir sehr gut gefallen. Aurel natürlich hier mit Asterios anfangs ein bisschen blöde und arrogant, wie man es halt, wie man es am Anfang hier gedacht hat, von einer Gokunen-Schwester. Aber hier, das mit Asterios war schon sehr emotional und sehr schön.
And sorrows are played out now. Oh, what a terrible time.
Die Prinzessin, die hier der Schlüssel an der Waage war.
Without me or my loser sister around, it's dreadfully boring. Although, I would like to meet him again someday. I'll have to call him by name and make fun of that embarrassing confession of love. Oh, that's right, Maxie. You did well too. As a final reward, I give you a little kiss. Get down on your knees, here.
Oh, wer mehr zur Stein?
What? Well, safe travels. Make your next struggle as merry as this one.
Ja, hoffen wir, dass sie Asterios nochmal findet. Und ja, wer weiß. Happily ever after leben.
Tschung, Miss! Sie hat mich geküsst.
Tja, und nun noch hier unser Wächter der Schatztruhe. Die zwar erst am Ende gekommen sind, aber Atalanta und David. Und Atalanta, die nun in einer deutlich heldenhafteren Form aufgetaucht sind.
Yo, I'm happy I was of service this time. I didn't want to be defeated like last time. That said, I haven't really shown what I can do yet, so please call on me again sometime. Still, from now on, how should I go about honoring Lady Artemis?
Maya, als Göttin der Jungfräulichkeit. Ach, David, mein Bro, dich habe ich doch eh meine Party.
Well, it's about that time. It seems you have various struggles ahead, but do your best without being discouraged. With two humans, Krell and Shoes, 100 will create competition, thousands will cause confrontation. That holds true no matter what era. You should fight your own battle. Please wait. You knew about the 72 demon gods. Was that, really a demon god? The doctor claims they don't exist.
Oh, did I say as much? Why would you think so?
Well, naturally, you're King David of Israel. You're all the fault of King Solomon.
Sag ich doch.
Who is said to have summoned the 72 demon gods?
Phew! It's true, Solomon is my son. But summoning spells are beyond my capabilities. How utterly useless.
Das sagst du, Dr. Roman.
Ah, rude. But what about yourself? It seems you said the demon god was no demon god. On what grounds?
Well, that's... It wasn't exactly my image of one or...
Aha, Roman is a fan of King Solomon. He has been an admirer for a long time.
Hey, Leonardo, that was a secret, a secret.
That's why you don't accept the demon god, isn't it? You don't want to believe your idol messed with such a disgusting things.
Right, you're correct. The 72 demon gods signify both the beginning and the pinnacle of summoning spells. They couldn't be foul creatures like that. I mean, he's King Solomon, you know? He's the king who held the omnipotent 10 rings, built the first temple in Jerusalem, and made Israel prosperous. How could someone like that command such monstrous or even worse plot? Plot the destruction of humanity!
There you go! As his father, what do you think, King David? Does King Solomon have a connection to demon god?
Solomon would do things like that, you know. Basically, he's a cruel, vulgar, good-for-nothing.
What? How terrible! I can't believe anything anymore.
Haha, my apology. It's my fault for not having much to do with Solomon. I was never interested in child rearing. But certainly, though he was a fool, he was honest. For destroying humanity history, well, I don't think he'd consider it unless he was betrayed by all 10 of his secret lovers.
In its own way, that makes him his image even worse.
Phew. Just how bad is the public image of King Solomon? Well, I must be going. I leave the rest to you. But if anything happens, don't hesitate to call on me. Das werden wir tun, David. Naja, und es fehlt natürlich noch eine. Right. So we still don't have any definitive information about the demon gods yet. But King Solomon is involved, and that's the ugly truth.
Doctor?
Oh no, never mind. Now Captain Francis Drake. Thank you very much. With so many special cases this time, I wasn't really much help. Lucky we had a dependable voyager like you on the side. Thanks to that, history has been successfully corrected.
Oh, it was nothing. I couldn't do much in the end.
Ah, if I could become one of these servants too, I'd be a little flashier. But I suppose that's an impossible request. A pirate like me could never be treated like a hero.
You're already a fine hero, Captain.
Oh, habt ihr gesehen, sie wird kurz rot. Really? Since that coming from you, I believe half of it. So if history is corrected, will I really lose my memories of all of you?
Wahrscheinlich.
Well, you don't have to say a word. That look on your face says everything.
Wahrscheinlich wie rot sie ist.
I see. I guess I can't sail around the world with you folks. A pity. But that's fine. Our time together was short, but it was a merry journey. So go. For seafarers, parting is always abrupt. Blown up by a cannonball, washed away by a wave, and ultimately lose sight of our destination and die. That's why we take care of those fears and always brush them off with a laugh.
Yes, goodbye. Captain who navigates across the seas of freedom. It's too bad during this journey. I wanted to discover my wish and report to you, Captain.
Hmm? What we talked about before? Oh, you're troublesome because you have no wishes. It bothered you that much? Don't be silly, Aretha. You already have a wish, Mesh. You know very well what you want to do.
Huh? Captain Drake, what do you mean?
Saying you have no wish is wrong. In the first place, nobody is without greed. All humans have some kind of wish. You can't live without one. The only difference is living while knowing what it is or spending the whole life not realizing it. Same with the Yazan guy. Even he dreamed of creating a utopia. His homeland banished him and didn't save him. I don't know if he did all this to prove them wrong. Still, he wanted his nation to be a peaceful one. The man was obsessed with the desire to rule, and at the very end he arrived at his true wish.
Yes, his actions and behaviors were reprehensible, but surprisingly he was thinking of the people. Though selfish, he was trying to protect others.
Aye, sometimes sinners do saintly deeds, while saints sin. That's humans for you, that us. That's why everyone got a wish. It's just some, go their whole life without realizing what their true wishes are.
Captain Drake, which type am I?
You're the type that's better of not realizing. You should stay just the way you are. I'm sure you'll know in the end. You'll realize what you want to do and why you continue to raise that shield to defend others. I'm the opposite, I already know. The sooner you know, the uglier the punchline ends up being.
Captain Drake, are you, from now on, your life?
It's fine. You needn't state the obvious. I know how it ends for me. I die, right? Life is interesting once you know you're going to die. No, because you will die, you want to live in the moment. I'm not really a fiend for treasure. What I want is money and pleasure. We are gonna die eventually, so I want to enjoy every single moment while I can. Thanks to you, I know how vast the world is. It's a never-ending journey, even if I go all out. I'd be satisfied to take just a little of that and blaze one of the many trails available. How blessed, how inconvenient, and how it would be just like what I wished an ending to be. So never mind, don't worry yourself over my dying days. Farewell, Mash and Maxi. You too, cowardly scholar guy. The reward for saving an era. Let's see. When your journey ends, just remember how much fun you had with me. That'll be enough. Will do. Farewell, Captain.
Welcome home. Good job, Maxi and Mash. This makes 3 eliminated singularities protecting human history. The admission is no longer just a pipe dream. I look into the demon god on my end. For the time being, I'll focus on King Solomon's era. I use Chaldea and Sheba to observe the Earth of 10,000 BC.
Are you sure? Sheba's range is the Christian era. Go back further than that, and you lose accuracy. Plus, it would require vast amounts of magical energy and electricity. Chaldea's current reserves aren't that.
With my pride on the line, I'll take care of that somehow. As for magical energy, I might know someone who can help.
Really? I thought chances for outside help were non-existent.
Foo?
Huh? Oh yeah, sorry. I had the wrong idea. I got by somehow with Da Vinci's dash. Anyway, you two need to unwind.
Next up is the fourth singularity, the turnabout point. Frost, Rome, and the sea. Each time the number of irregularities has been increasing. Maybe with the next singularity, the real target will come. That's why I want you to rest up. We've got some time until the next ray shift.
Foo! Good job, Senpai. You did your best too, Foo.
QQ!
By the way, Senpai, did you want to sail around the world with Drake?
Let's go after this is over.
After our battle is over? Yes, not a trip via ray shift, but a journey in this era. I want to enjoy a world in which the future isn't decided yet, just like Captain Drake. Senpai, I think this recent search for the Holy Grail was the most special case for us so far. The process slowly was to head somewhere. It was a battle on a seemingly endless sea. Along the way, I think I learned something. Good and bad people alike contribute to human history, human diversity and contradictions, exceptions too. Humans are brutal creatures. They use wisdom and gain power for their own desires and objectives. That is truly brutal trait. You could say that they are the most powerful and barbaric organism on the planet. But there's hope in their brutality. The hope of realizing what couldn't be realized. The power not to let the impossible remain impossible. This power is hope. She taught us that is what makes us human. I don't know if I have such a power, but I'd like to get as close as I can. So I can keep fighting by your side, Senpai, to become a servant that you can be proud of someday. Now then, Senpai, foo, sweet dreams. We are on dry land for the first time in a long while. We don't have to worry about getting seasick anymore. Please, have a nice and long rest.
Und Ladies and Gentlemen, das war die dritte Singularität. Ich hoffe, wir kriegen wieder einen Servant. Wahrscheinlich bekommen wir dann Astorius. Right, Servant. Nee, wenn schon David. Liebe Leute, wir haben die dritte Singularität der Seasons of Four Seas Oceanus Voyage of the Storm geschafft. Die dritte Singularität hat die Grand Order hier erledigt und als Belohnung erhalten wir eine Kiste mit einem Heiligen Gral. Können wir uns ganz langsam ins Regal stellen. David has it sent to your present box. So, da la, liebe Leute, sacken wir noch unsere Belohnungen ein. Ach, ein kleiner David. Ist er nicht süß. Den kann man immer gut gebrauchen, denn ein David ist besser als kein David. Dazu holen wir uns noch satte 10 Quartz ab dafür, dass wir die dritte Singularität abgeschlossen haben. Tja, Leute, mein Fazit. Also, liebe Leute, eine Singularität, die mir jetzt wieder sehr gut gefallen hat. Am Anfang hatte sie dasselbe Problem wie Septem. Dass sie ein wenig langsam war, dass die Geschichte nicht ewig gebraucht hat, bis sie in Fahrt gekommen ist und eher, dass man halt nicht so richtig das Gefühl hat, dass es vorangeht. Aber am Ende jetzt wirklich, also wirklich ab zu dem letzten Drittel, schon eigentlich ab der Hälfte, wurde es verdammt spannend. Die Geschichte war cool, also am Anfang, wie gesagt, war es halt wirklich, wir sind Klabautermänner und segeln über die Meere. Und das war, wie gesagt, dasselbe, was in Septem eben nicht ganz so gut war, dass es einfach viel zu langsam, sage ich, also viel zu unkonventionell war. Es war halt einfach so, ja, man ist halt so dahergesiegt. Aber wiederum, in dieser Kampagne war es deutlich besser. In Okeanos sind wir dann hier, nachdem wir dann immer mehr Charaktere kennengelernt haben, hier auf eine richtig emotionalen Geschichte hier gewandert. Asturias und Orys hier, kleine Liebesgeschichte, die hier ziemlich süß war. Und immer wieder, dass noch ein Böserer dahinter steckt. Er ist dann Blackbeard, der perverse Pirat hier mit Anne Bonny, was ganz nett war. Dann, dass in Wahrheit nur ein Verräter ist hier, Hector, und in Wahrheit für Jason arbeitet. Das waren alles gute Twists. Und dann hier wirklich am Ende dieser Battle gegen Herkules, wo du, Alter, merkst, der Typ ist unbesiegbar. Du hast keine Chance gegen ihn. Und du alles benutzen musst. Die Hilfe von allen Servant hier benutzen musst, um den zu bezwingen. Was verdammt cool war. Und dann schließe ich hier am Ende nochmal ein Showdown. Wir sind immer noch nicht weiter im Endeffekt, aber trotzdem... Es war ein cooles Finale hier. Bevor wir nochmal zum Fazit kommen. Also, wie gesagt, wir wissen nun, dass Solomon dahinter steckt. Das war ja uns schon klar. 72 Demon-Götter, die Solomon beschwert hat. Der Sohn von David. Das heißt, wenn wir David töten als Servant, muss dann auch in der Vergangenheit doch auch dann eher ausgelöscht werden. Funktioniert das so mit den Singularitäten? Ich glaube nicht. Nichtsdestotrotz war es das natürlich immer noch nicht. Wir müssen David aufhalten. David, verzeihung. Wir müssen Solomon aufhalten und die anderen Dämonenfürste bezwingen. Deswegen werden wir in die anderen Singularitäten noch reisen. Okeanos ist vorbei. Die See, die hier sehr viele coole Charaktere hatten. Drake auch, die sehr sympathisch war und dieses so ein bisschen auch Mesh hier nach vorne gepusht hat hier als Charakter. War eine super Reise. Mir hat es saumäßig viel Spaß gemacht. Aber nun, so wie es aussieht, wird es düster. Wir werden uns das nächste Mal ins 19. Jahrhundert, ins Jahr 1888 begeben. Der Mist City London. Dort werden wir in das nebelverhangene London reisen und ich denke mal auf Servants wie, ich denke mal unsere Jackie hier treffen. Wo ist sie denn? Jackie, oh, oh, oh. Ich denke mal, du wirst beim nächsten Mal auftreten. Wie und in welcher Form werden wir erfahren. Doch jetzt verabschiede ich mich mal. Ich war's, euer MC Mafix, und bis zur nächsten Kampagne. Haut rein und auf Wiedersehen. Ciao.